soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord.
Entering into the order of Christ, into Jesus, into the divine volition, I find everyone and everything. So finding everyone, I invite all souls of all times to join me today in honouring the Immaculate Conception of our dearest Mother and the Mother of our Lord Jesus. What a wonderful opportunity in Advent to look at where it all began, in the great gift of the Immaculate Conception of the one who was to be the Mother of the Incarnate Word. We begin by recapitulating the entire life of Mary before the supreme majesty of the Father. Having the courage to do this through the humanity of Jesus, we approach the throne of God, bearing all the thoughts, words, steps, works, heartbeats and breaths of the Holy Mother. As a most refulgent and glorious bouquet of roses, violets and lilies, we place all these thoughts, words, steps, works, heartbeats and breaths of Mama Mary in the lap of the Heavenly Father and say, Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, along with your Son Jesus, we offer to you the entire life recapitulated from the first instant of her Immaculate Conception, of the tiny little one who is to become Mary, mother of your Son. We travel through her life, collecting every tear shed on behalf of all her poor children, every kiss she gave to Jesus, your and her Son, every prayer she offered to you for the Redeemer to be born, every act in obedience to first her parents, then from the tender age of 3 years, obedience to the bell in the temple, calling her to her various little prayers and acts, attending to the needs in the temple. We offer to you the obedience in faith when she was given in marriage to Joseph, her most chaste spouse, even when she was held in a vow of virginity to you, and her sweet delight when discovering Joseph had also given his vow. We offer every act of keeping the house in Nazareth, the promptness in which she said, Fiat mihi, to the angel Gabriel, who announced that she was to be the mother of the Redeemer, and in going to visit her oldest cousin, Elizabeth, also with child, in a miraculous way. We offer the prayer of the Magnificat, a wonderful prayer of glory to you, Father, from the lips of your dear daughter. Father, we desire to offer to you all the acts of our sweet Mama Mary, during the time she waited for the birth of her dear baby son, your son, Jesus, and as she and Joseph travelled to Bethlehem, the place where he was to be born as prophesied long ago. We offer the difficulties of that journey and the distance travelled, every step of Joseph, and every step of the donkey which carried the Immaculate Conception to you for your infinite, perfect and eternal glory. We offer the birth of Jesus and all the acts surrounding that most prodigious birth. The star which you had set in the heavens to guide the men from distant lands to your Son. The angels in the heavens singing of the arrival of he who would save his people. The shepherds who responded and the many others who visited the new little family. We offer the tears of Mama Mary at the circumcision, the presentation of Jesus and the response of Simeon and Anna, the flight into Egypt, the return and all the acts pertaining to these events. We offer to you, Father, the days of Mary, Jesus and Joseph as Jesus grew and the pain and sorrow Mary experienced in the loss of Jesus when he remained behind in the temple. The acceptance of Mary to everything that occurred with a fiat, whether she suffered pain or joy. We offer you all her acts during the time of her beautiful son and God's passion, and we offer her standing at the foot of the cross. Father, we offer to you every instant of our dear mother's life, all live for you in the divine will, never taking back her own will. And finally, dear Father, we offer the glorious assumption into heaven and the coronation of our dear, holy, pure, and beautiful Mother to you. Amen. Fiat, fiat, fiat.